Hey, hey, what's up? How's it going? How are we doing? How are we feeling today? How are we vibing? Is it the vibe today? Are we vibing? Is that.
Are we doing that? Okay.
Okay, can we talk about what our least favorite season is? Because mine is spring. Because why? Allergies. I'm allergic to grass and trees. I'm struggling out here, but it's okay. So, what are we doing here? Okay. Hey, what's up? How are you doing? It's me, and today is a new day, and that day is a great day because we are up and moving, and you are here looking at me talking and doing things. Okay, hey, I should probably introduce myself. Hi, how are you doing? My name is Theron Howard. On this channel, I like to do things that interest me, and this is one of those things that I'm doing right now in this video that you're watching that I made. Okay.
Hey, again.
Coming at you.
Again.
So here's the thing. I feel like all of the other projects that I've done have been copies, to say the very least, right? And this time, I actually want to do something out of my own creative volition. So I'm going to be
trying
thing and seeing how it turns out. Now, is there a vision? Kind of. There's kind of a vision, but is that vision. Good. No. I don't know what it is. I really don't know what the vision is. It's not even that established. It's kind of simple. Basically, silhouettes are cool to me. So what I want to try to do is make silhouettes into something. You know, use silhouettes
in a cool way.
I had this one idea to like make like a picture of somebody sitting down. Well, it's gonna be me because I have nobody here. Well, this was my vision. Like, okay, so it's like me sitting down and kind of just like sitting there, and it's like kind of like and then like an overbearing like thought, like another like a different version of me is like looking over. You know what I mean? I don't know if this is making any sense, but it looked a little bit too sciencey in my head, a little bit too fantastical, too Doctor Strange. And I was not going for that. I just want something kind of simple, kind of calm to look at, but also kind of, I don't know, kind of inward. You know? If that makes any sense. This doesn't make any sense. I'm just gonna try something out. We're gonna see how it goes, and you're joining me on this journey. If you want to, you can always leave. But you're here now, so I mean, you might as well. Oh, you don't have to do anything. You really don't. You don't. I'm just, letting you know. Because, I'm just making you aware of the situation. You were probably already aware of the situation. I'm just reintroducing the situation to you. Nobody asked, but I did do that. I did that now, so I'm gonna do. Okay, so everything's fine. That. Oh, yeah! By the way, yes, I know. I'm in a different spot today. A blank wall. Do we like it? Do we like a blank wall? Let me know. Okay, let's get into it. See what happens. Okay. I set this up. Here's what I have going on. You see it? This is the camera. Then I have this light here just to make things more defined. Okay, so my plan is to try and get these pictures to be as sharp as they can, because it's gonna be blacked out because it's a silhouette, right? But I want to make sure all the details, like the outline, is there. So that's why I kind of put the light, so it'll be easier for me to like separate it from the wall in Photoshop. Does that make sense? It makes sense in my head, but we'll see how this goes. Okay, I hope you can see everything. It's kind of a simple setup, but let's see how it goes. We're bringing back the click and hide. I think we're bringing back the click and hide, because I don't know where else, how else to do this without our friend here, so. My standards were already low because this shouldn't be hard, but this one's also going all right so far. And I'm not mad about it. Now, let's just keep going.
I want it to look like they're searching or somebody's leaving. That's good. That's so good.
I don't know why, but I feel like I should take my LinkedIn headshot right now because it's like a clean background, but it's like I also don't want to do that. You know what I mean? Like taking advantage of these opportunities. I don't know. Okay, now I'm gonna try like a different one because I feel like those turned out all right. I'm gonna try like, because you know, we were thinking somebody's leaving, so why don't we just like capitalize on that and try it with like somebody walking away? Of course, like we need both sides of the story. That could be a silhouette too.
Okay. that was awkward.
I'm stressed. How does one walk in a picture normally? How do you do that? Because I don't know how, and it's like causing problems. I mean, it looks like it's causing problems. It feels like it's causing problems. Let's look at it. Yeah, those are embarrassing to look at, so we're not, yeah, that's, oh, you know what? I learned a trick. I saw like an Instagram thing, like a reel where you can like lift the front of your foot and the back of your other foot, and it's supposed to look like walking. Let's try that.
It's kind of hard, honestly. This is difficult. Maybe these should be shameful. Let's see if it looks like. Why? I have no balance. Let's try again. It might not even look like anything.
I'm gonna put my chin down. We had the conversation about being a mom, which is not the case right now, because this is hard. It's like it's hard. I'm gonna try something different. If you could see how bad that looked. If you could see it, it's so bad. You will not be seeing that. Okay, I think we got it, and I'm not doing anymore. So, I mean, it's usually like this. I think that I get it, and I don't want to do anymore, so I'm stopping. We didn't even take that many pictures. We took 28 pictures, which is kind of a lot, but also not. Anyway, hey again. What's up? How you doing? How was that? If you could rate that on a scale of 1 to 10 on how awesome and fun and cool it was, would it get a 10? I mean, that's all I'm trying to understand. So let me know. But I'm just going to let you peek into what's going on in my mind right now. My mind says, let's go to Atlanta. Well, that was fun, right? Yeah, a little trip. Anyway, let's get back into the editing. Let's go back to your regularly scheduled program.
Hey, what's up? What is up? You're gonna laugh, because, you know, I'm trying to laugh. I'm not happy, but it's okay. I completely and utterly lost the video of me editing. The video of my face. But here's the thing. You know, I still have the screen recording. So I'm thinking, I'm just gonna play it. And you're gonna get a rundown from this version of me. Is that alright? I mean, I hope so. I can't tell. But it's like, I'm doing it regardless. Because I feel bad. But it's okay. It's okay.
Okay, we're moving fast, so I gotta talk fast. So of course, you know, we're looking at the favorite picture. What's our favorite? Oh yeah, awesome, standing. Oh, footwork, on point. We love it all. Let's pick our favorites. Yeah, these are the favorites. Awesome, cool, wow. Now, let's move on. Okay, we're moving on. We're in Photoshop now. I hope you're keeping up. Okay, so I gotta pick out a gradient. I'm not good with gradients, but it's okay. I'll pick out some purple and blue because I'm feeling like it that day. I gotta make some hills and shapes. So that's what I'm going for next, right? Because I want some hills in this picture. It's a silhouette situation. So I make it the right color. It's hills. Everything's going great. And then I gotta make some patterns because I want some grass. So I look for the stamp. Oh, it's not working. I figured out we could use trees. So I ended up using a tree, which took up just way too much space on my laptop because it's making everything slow. But that's okay. It's okay.
So, we're back here. I have to fill you in about a couple things because, as you saw, my scratch discs were full, so I really could not record anymore of the screen. So I do apologize. I'm going to figure that out for next time. But besides that, here's the thing. I did capture some screenshots of moments that I thought were funny as I was making this. I'll just let them play. I mean, doesn't it look funny? Doesn't it look just kind of a little goofy? It looked goofy to me. Anyway, so after I was done filling them in and I used like the paint bucket, like in the last video, I kind of just like traced out myself and then I copy and pasted it into the other picture. And then I filled it in with a paint bucket so that it became completely black. Okay, that makes sense. Of course, we saw how the grass was going. And I used this like blending, like the Band-Aid icon. I forgot what it was called, but I used that to make more grass. To make it look more organic, I guess, because, you know, you could see the edges of the thing, of the shapes, of the ovals. So it looked kind of jarring. It looked kind of stark. So I tried to fix that. Once I was done with the picture, I had this. And I kind of thought that it wasn't enough. It felt like it was missing something. So I thought about what I've been enjoying lately. If you know me in, like, real life, kind of thing. This is real life, but you know what I mean. I very much enjoy the vintage aesthetic. Each of these different aspects of the vintage aesthetic, I like to associate with different decades, or associated with different decades, or time periods, or whatever. For example, I like vintage cars and stuff like that, but I mostly like the cars from the 1950s, 60s era. And then, like, for vintage clothes, I'm very much a person who enjoys the 80s and 90s kinds of looks, which sometimes I have just the strongest unction to dress like I'm from the 80s, but I just do not have the closet for it, but it's okay. It's fine. It's not fine, but it's fine. And I like a lot of different kinds of music, but I like oldies music as well, which is more music from the 1930s, and technically all the way up until like the 90s too. But like each of those little decades, like the 30s, 40s, 50s, and then jumping up to like the 80s again. All music is great. Anyway, that's something that I enjoy. So I thought about film pictures, like that kind of film photography, those kinds of vintage pictures. And I thought that that's the kind of thing that I should try and add to this one. So after that, I came up with the final picture. Are you ready? I mean, you pretty much already know what it looks like because it didn't look that much different, but this is what it is. What do we think? I'm not even gonna lie to you. I feel like I'm not even fooling you right now. Like, I definitely went to Atlanta, but I didn't just go to Atlanta right now. I put this on to try and trick you. Did that work? It didn't work. Because you're smart. You're an educated scholar viewer. You wouldn't fall for that. So I apologize for assuming that you wouldn't. That's honestly borderline disrespectful of me. And I apologize because you deserve the utmost respect. So I apologize. And I will continue apologizing until I stop, which is now. I'm sorry, but now we're moving on. Okay, let's recap. I thought this whole process was fine. I thought it was kind of fun, honestly. It's always been fun, but I felt like it felt more fun because I didn't know exactly what I wanted to do. I was coming up with it as I went, and things were changing as I was going, and it was, you know, it wasn't very risky. It was fun to try something new. It didn't feel like I was gambling in any way, something like that. Like, it wasn't serious, but it felt fun, especially because I didn't know which direction I was going, right? That can be fun. A little bit of a spontaneity in that. Anyway, I thought that the picture taking was fun. We tried some things out, and I'm actually surprised that it turned out the way it did, because the camera angle was too high, and I like expressed that before. Like, it wasn't as flat, like it wasn't like eye level, which I thought might be an issue for the pictures. It ended up looking okay, and I wonder what it would look like if the camera when I was taking the pictures was more flat, you know what I mean? So the image looked more 2D. I mean, that's not what we did, so we won't know what that looks like until I try this again. I'm glad that I did the vintage kind of film feel to the picture, because I feel like it adds more to it. I don't know why, but once I did that, I kind of found more meaning in it. And I know I didn't make it with meaning, so like I don't know if I can regard it with any meaning, but it felt like it had more meaning once I made it a whole thing and like kind of saw it as its full image. And you know, I also felt like it just generally looked a little bit cool, kind of simple but cool. I mean, I'm proud of it. Of course, I could always have done better, but I did my best, and you can never do better than your best. So, well, anyway, like I always do. Whoa, I was about to say I'm gonna tag the photographer, but I did it. I am the photographer. So you know what? I will tag the photographer. at the end of this.
I hope you had fun watching this. It's kind of a shorter one. I've needed bouts of encouragement to start a channel and really express my passions to other people and share, just because I was nervous and scared to kind of put myself out there. But at the end of the gosh darn day, I'm glad that I am, because I mean, if nothing, I'm having fun expressing this and sharing this and just generally enjoying this. So I hope that in any way, if you feel like you can't express yourself, or if you've been too nervous to do so in whatever passion that you're passionate about, I encourage you to do that for yourself. Share it if you want to share it. If you don't, that's totally fine. Just do what you gotta do. Have fun. Enjoy what you enjoy. So I hope you have a great, awesome, fantastic rest of your day or night whenever you're watching this. And I'll see you next time. Bye.